Hey guys, welcome to Beyond the Brick. This is Mike. I'm kind of quiet because this is Nathan Sawaya behind the camera getting an interview for another media outlet, but I'm here in LA in Hollywood to give you a tour of his studio. Maybe I think there might have been a tour already on this channel, but this is 2019, so we'll see what new is up. And I'm waiting for Nathan to finish his interview so we can actually get him on camera and show us the amazing things. Before that happens, I want to show you how the entrance of the studio is looking like. And when you enter to this small building in North Hollywood, it actually strikes you with some really crazy sculptures, so check them out. So this is the famous sculpture that I think was appearing many times over on the internet with the intestines and everything. It's really amazing. I don't want to touch anything and break anything, but here it is.
Hi, I'm Nathan Sawaya from The Art of the Brick, which is my exhibition that's been touring the globe for several years now. And this is my art studio here in Los Angeles. We're going to walk around a bit. I'll give you a brief tour. Some of these sculptures you may recognize. A few of them have been part of The Art of the Brick for years. And several of them actually right here are the prototypes. Some are unglued prototypes from when I very, very early on started. One second, my dog back here has found some pizza. Boo! This is my dog, Boo. She works with me in the art studio every day. She comes and sits at my feet while I'm working. All right, let's go in the studio. So this is where I do most of the work. I have about a million Lego bricks here and with a few million offsite. You're looking at some prototypes from over the years, various forms of Hugman creatures. A lot to see, I suppose. This is a Pac-Man machine that's actually functioning, built out of a few thousand bricks a few years ago. Here's a larger form of Yellow. This was a piece that took me, I think, almost 4 or 5 weeks to build. So it was a beast of a creation. You also see a guitar here. This was a fun build that I did just recently. I posted a time-lapse video of me building it on my Instagram recently. Here's a red dress. This is from the In Pieces collection. The In Pieces collection was a collaboration with Dean West, who is a photographer, and we worked together to incorporate items built out of Lego bricks into his hyper-realistic photography. We had a model wearing this dress in an image for the In Pieces exhibition. This figure back here is actually Justin Willman from The Magician. This was used in a magic trick, a magic illusion, I should say, several years ago. As you can see back here, this is how all the bricks are sorted and stored. They're in clear plastic bins so I can quickly know how many bricks I have and what I need. As I said, about a million bricks here. I keep a few million offsite in storage. What else? Here's one of my larger creations. This is a swimmer swimming on the ground here. The leg actually comes out this way. This is one of the longer pieces I've worked on over the years. I've done a smaller version that travels with The Art of the Brick, but this is a larger version. As you can see, all the elements that I use for building are sorted right right here on the shelves in clear bins.
I am more than impressed. I mean, I've been in my fair share in cool LEGO offices and places, but this is something new. I'm also familiar with your work quite a bit. I think we mentioned them in a bunch of videos. What's the biggest creation here? Like, is that bear behind us? The biggest in terms of bricks used? What do you think?
The polar bear. I would say the polar bear is probably one of the largest pieces here. Maybe large yellow over there, the big yellow. But they're somewhere in the same range, for sure.
And we're kind of here in LA because you are involved in the LEGO Masters show.
Yes.
And what's your role in the show? Just like briefly tell us what's your job there, like without revealing too much.
Right. I am a consulting producer on LEGO Masters Season 1 and very excited to be a part of it. I've been working with them for the last several months doing creations for the show. Some of it is set dressing, you know, props that you see around the show. Other things are working on the actual challenges, creating things that the contestants will be using or building off of for part of their challenges. So it's been a fun process.
So will you be appearing on the show, like in the frame, or are you just like behind the scenes mastermind that does the cool stuff and that people get to build in the show?
No, I'm behind the scenes. I'm doing a lot of the work, you know, when we need to build something quickly. They call me and I build it as fast as I can to get it to set.
The show was around in different countries. This is the first time it's in the US. And you're like the perfect person, at least in my opinion, for this, because you've been working with millions of bricks. So I think that probably most of the stuff that was built in the show didn't really like surprise you in a way, because I mean, you're known as one of the biggest sculpture builders in the world right now, right? Was there a thing that really struck you that was like a new experience for you, given the fact that your background with LEGO is that much crazy and it's so insane, actually?
Yeah, I mean, we tried some things in this show that have never been done before out of LEGO.
Like super secret, so we're going to have to watch the show in February.
Oh, yeah, you definitely have to watch. And I think LEGO fans are really going to get a kick out of it. We've got some great guests, some special guests on the show, and there's some really fun challenges. I think we tried to do some things out of LEGO that are a little unexpected. And for me, it was a different type of challenge because, as you said, I'm used to working on sculptural things, large sculptures over time. This was much faster building, and sometimes it was different scales. Whereas I like, usually work on large scale human forms, life size human forms, at least. This was sometimes at a different scale, much smaller. So it challenged me at times, but it was good for me. And I think it was really a lot of fun. I can't wait for everyone to see it.
We are, I think, at the end of the production. So they're filming the last episode as of today.
Yeah.
And I think you and me will be experiencing, I know you mentioned that with the other interview, that you want to see the final cut. Because you were working like from different angle, behind the scenes kind of thing. And me too, like I watched all of these like MasterChef shows and kind of like the thing. So after it's a finished product, it's like a lot of editing involved. And like, I kind of want to see how I compare the actual set I saw today with, and probably you saw over the last few months, with the actual production that comes out on TV.
Exactly. It's a beautiful set, but there's going to be a lot that happens, you know, between now and when it actually airs. And so I'm very excited to see what it looks like.
Thank you so much, Nathan. Your studio is amazing. I'm going to snoop around here, probably get some B-roll shots and like maybe steal some bricks. Don't tell him. But no, I will just like wish you the best of luck with the finishing of the show, which you're still involved with. I hope we can all watch it together at some point and it's going to be amazing. Thank you so much for having us. This is Nathan Sawaya and Mike from Beyond the Brick. And I hope to see you in the next episode because we have different interviews and things from the LEGO Masters behind the scenes. And just click the links below. It's all there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.